The city's longest-serving incumbent councillor is stepping down at the October election. Neil Collins confirmed recently this year will be the last in his career that began in 1989. Councillor Collins joins us tonight. Good evening.
Becca.
What first got you into local politics?
Well, oddly enough, I was made redundant on state radio back in the late 80s, and I started writing a column for the Otago Daily Times on Saturday mornings called the Collins Report, and in that I often referred to things around the city which I thought could be improved or bettered, and it was actually the then editor of the Otago Daily Times that urged me to stand for council, that and quite a few other people, and so I did, and it was successful and been there ever since.
Can you give us an overview of the roles that you've held in your council career?
Well, quite a number, obviously, over those years. But I've been a deputy chair for a couple of committees, what we call infrastructure services, water waste and all that type of stuff. And deputy chair of the planning and environment. I was the chairman of a civic committee that we had, and that introduced, among other things, the sister city agreement that we have with Shanghai. That was a rather tortured path to get it underway, but that was very successful, and it just served on quite a number of other committees as well.
What has been the most difficult aspect to date?
I think you know the answer to that. It's probably fair to say the most difficult would have been the Forsyth Bar Stadium. But we had to do something. Carisbrook was disintegrating, and it gave us a profile that really is accepted now worldwide. We've had a World Rugby Cup there. We've had numerous events that would not have been staged in the city. Otherwise, you look back over the last 2 years and you'll see that a lot of things have come to Dunedin that wouldn't have otherwise.
Mm. What's been the most satisfying aspect?
Most satisfying? Well, I suppose from a personal point of view, it would be getting free parking in the city for people over 75. Anything that does that has got to be good. And I think so, because people have paid rates for a long time and they deserve something back. Various other things. I got the Art Society, for instance, to move from the Bluestone building that you've been featuring recently down to the railway station, and I was instrumental in that. Probably just basic stuff, Rebecca, getting cleaner and better drinking water for the city through the 90s. That was something pretty important for people. And basic stuff like sewage, getting raw sewage out of our Otago Harbour, stuff like that.
Why have you decided to step down now?
Well, it is my time. It's, as you said, I've been there a long time, and I've got a few health issues. There's a bit of medical science keeping the motor running in here at the moment. So it was my time to step aside.
What's kept you in the role for so long then?
Satisfaction with the role, and I think probably what I was getting done here and there. It's not all done in the public glare. There's a lot of things behind the scenes, as you'd imagine. So general satisfaction. I know it sounds a bit trite to say it, but you're giving back to the community and serving the people, and you feel you're doing a bit of good.
What sort of advice would you give to any of the new councillors that might come out of the October election?
What advice? Ignore my advice. I don't know. I would say above all else, take a positive attitude into council. There's too much negativity around today. Get a positive attitude in there. Do what you can. And above all, remember people who are struggling financially in this city and keep the rates to an affordable level.
Sounds like good advice to me. Councillor Neil Collins, thank you very much for your time now and over the years.
You're welcome.